Okay, now you look at the video. Okay, spatula in your house.
Okay, okay. So I put in a little sugar, a little salt, olive oil, extra virgin oil.
Got all the good stuff.
How much did you put in?
Would you like a whisk?
No, this is going to be good enough.
Are you sure? Yeah. Mm-hmm. You need very little.
Okay, so I told you how the bread flour I sort of practice with it. You can use any bread flour in the world for pizza.
Okay.
You can use, like, all-purpose, even peach flour. But what we've been finding is that the white bread flour,
unbleached bread flour.
That's our favorite.
Okay.
It makes a nice crispy crust.
Oh.
And
for pizza.
Excellent. And it'll make great ciabatta when
You make ciabatta?
I love ciabatta.
Oh, you can make that.
My most favorite thing in the whole world.
Okay.
Do you like focaccia?
No, I like ciabatta.
Oh. So the no need to eat recipe will
make
tell you how to
really
easy.
Oh my god.
And your whole place smells so great.
Delicious.
I knew I'd found Angel.
Oh, I wish I could sing your lyrics together.
Got some salt, kosher or sea salt.
Right.
You've got a little bit of sugar, cane sugar.
Yes, a touch.
And a little bit of olive oil.
Right.
Extra virgin. You can mix all this stuff. Okay, so, but here's the thing that I'm not really sure about, because I never measured how much flour. I think the ratio of flour to water is something like 1 1/3 to 1 1/2 to 1.
I think maybe it's how it feels.
Right.
How the dough feels.
And actually, here we are in Hawaii, and it's humid, and we're up high. What's the elevation here?
1,300 feet.
Oh, see, that's kind of high. We're down in Seattle
at sea level.
Sea level.
Yeah.
And it's not real humid.
Oh, okay.
This will be different.
So,
okay.
Feels the same. Okay, yeah. Now I was telling you about flour. See, that's the other thing. We like unbleached whole bread flour.
Right.
And actually,
that's it, honey.
The very best one we've ever found. Is this brand, Stone Burr?
It's called Stone
Burr. But it has a little thing here. It's called Shepherd's Grain.
Oh.
And it's actually these small farmers in eastern Washington.
Really?
They don't send it to the big producers or whatever they're called.
It's like a...
They do their own thing. And so we like it.
It's like a cottage industry.
Right.
And it's branded for these farmers.
How wonderful.
And it's a great flower.
Oh.
Okay, this is good. The other one is, and really good, is King Arthur.
Now that's what you mentioned today,
and we found it.
We went to KTA, we went to Safeway, we went to Foodland. We didn't go to Sac and Save. We got this at
KTA.
We did.
But on the way home, we drove to Foodland and we found it.
You found King Arthur?
Yeah. King Arthur.
Really?
It's the blue label.
Yeah.
It says unbleached bread flour.
Uh-huh. So
blue label.
You can get King
Arthur. My goodness. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, that's good.
I'm just
going to
dump this in there.
Okay, you don't need a whip.
No.
You use a...
This is kind of no need to knead it. You can knead it if you want.
It's going to be too wet right now, though.
Yeah. Okay, so we need some more... Should I measure it or not?
No, pretty you just do it. Until
you get to the right...
consistency.
Yeah.
Right? You know, that's what real cooking is about,
right?
Yeah.
See? It's already turning out right.
Yeah. We're just talking about how great your
skin is. Actually, you could leave it like this.
Never miss, you know.
And it's very wet, of course. You could never need this.
Right.
You could put some saran wrap on it and put it in there. Okay.
I would put more flour in it.
What I do is I typically don't put, you know, the exact perfect mixture in there until just before the last rise.
Okay, you don't put all the flour in before the last rise.
Well, okay, unless I'm doing it like if I was 2 hours before, sure,
right. Okay.
Then I might do that.
Okay.
But this thing is so forgiving. See how wet it is?
Now, this is really great. I think it's getting to a really good point here.
But, and I'm sure you know this. You know, it is the texture.
I know nothing.
It's the feel.
It's the feel, yeah.
And notice how it's still sticking. It's sticking to
but it's forming a ball.
I mean, she makes fresh pasta too, but she doesn't use a pasta maker.
No.
Ooh, more flour tomorrow, but this is all right. This will make
okay,
it nice.
Okay, we're nice.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So at the rest of the time, we should put the flour in and let it sit outside.
So for how long will we do that then? If we have to put more flour in, can we not do this all right now and let it?
Right. Tomorrow we could do a one-hour ride.
The one-hour ride, you add more flour?
Yes. Okay. Until it's just about right.
Now, do I have to put something on top of this?
I like to put...
Like a parchment paper?
I like to use saran wrap, plastic wrap.
Okay, I don't have...
Set it out.
Oh, we could set it out. So at what time do we need to complete this?
Tomorrow morning, like...
Around 8?
At the latest, 1 hour before you want to...
Okay, so like say 7 o'clock. We should,
because if we're going to have breakfast pizza,
yeah.
We need to, you know.
The other thing is, of course, the toppings and all of that.
Okay, no, we're going to do that in the morning.
Yeah.
So when I have everything.
When we get up, we'll have our coffee and we'll do the toppings
together.
We'll do
the toppings.
And then that'll give us an hour to do the pizza for breakfast. And that'll be perfect.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay.
So we'll get up and do the toppings
together. 7 o'clock, we'll moisten it.
Yeah, right.
Absolutely wonderful. Yes, Robert.
Okay, so Robert, where are we in this process of making a pizza?
We are T-minus 12 hours.
T-minus 12 hours!
And we're all going to get up and cut stuff.
We are!
Because
you know what? We have everything. We have Canadian bacon, mushroom, spinach, we have everything.
Oh, wow.
Yes, we have everything.